Merong mga nahalukay ako ng mga ibang mga dati pang mga usury law. Subukan natin basahin para may compare natin yung ibang mga amendment na yan. So kaya naisipan ko na rin na ano, basahin natin to, no? So sige, babasahin ko na po. Ito ay from Malacañang Presidential Decree number 116, January 29, 1973. Amending further certain sections of Act number 2655 as amended, otherwise known as the Usury Law. Whereas the interest rate, together with other monetary and credit policy instruments, performs a vital role in mobilizing domestic savings and attracting capital resources into preferred areas of investments. Whereas the monetary authorities have recognized the need to amend the present usury law to allow for more flexible interest rate ceilings that would be more responsive to the requirements of changing economic conditions. Whereas the availability of adequate capital resources is, among other factors, a decisive element in the achievement of the declared objective of accelerating the growth of the national economy. Now, therefore, Ferdinand E. Marcos, President of the Philippines, by virtue of the powers vested by the Constitution as Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces of the Philippines and pursuant to Proclamation Number 1081 dated September 21, 1972 and General Order Number 1 dated September 22, 1972 as amendment and in order to effect the desired changes and reforms in the social, economic, and political structure of our society do hereby order and decree the amendment of Act Number 2655 as amended as follows. Section 1. Section 1 of Act Number 2655 is hereby amended to read as follows. Section 1. The rate of interest for the loan or forbearance of any money, goods, or credit, and the rate allowed in judgments, in the absence of express contract as to such rate of interest, shall be fixed per centrum per annum, or such rate as may be prescribed by the Monetary Board of the Central Bank of the Philippines for that purpose in accordance with the authority hereby granted. Section 2. The same act is hereby amended by adding the following section immediately after the section 1 thereof, which reads as follows. Section 1A. The Monetary Board is hereby authorized to prescribe the maximum rate or rate of interest for the loan or renewal thereof or the forbearance of any money, goods, or credits, and to change such rate or rates whenever warranted by prevailing economic and social condition provided that such changes shall not be made oftener than once every 12 months. In the exercise of the authority herein granted, the Monetary Board may prescribe higher maximum rates for consumer loans or renewals thereof, as well as such loans made by pawnshops, finance companies, and other similar credit institutions, although the rates prescribed for this institution need not necessarily be uniform. Section 3. Section 2 of the same Act is hereby amended to read as follows. Section 2. No person or corporation shall directly or indirectly take or receive in money or other property, real or personal, or choose in action a higher rate of interest or greater sum of value, including commissions, premiums, fines, and penalties, for the loan or renewal thereof, or forbearance of money, goods or credits, where such loan or renewal or forbearance is secured in whole or in part by a mortgage upon real estate, the title to which is duly registered, or by any document conveying such real estates or an interest therein, than 12 per centrum per annum, on the maximum rate prescribed by the Monetary Board and enforced at the time the loan or renewal thereof or forbearance is granted, provided that the rate of interest under this section or the maximum rate of interest that may be prescribed by the Monetary Board under this section may likewise apply to loans secured by other types of security as may be specified by the Monetary Board. Section 4. Section 3 of the same Act is hereby amended to read as follows. Section 3. No person or corporation shall directly or indirectly demand, take, receive, or agree to charge in money or other property, real or personal, a higher rate or greater sum of value, for the loan or forbearance is not secured as provided in Section 2 hereof than 14 per centrum per annum, or the maximum rate or rates prescribed by the Monetary Board and enforced at the time the loan or forbearance is granted. Section 5. Section 4 of the same Act is hereby amended to read as follows. Section 4. No pawnbroker or pawnbroker's agent shall directly or indirectly stipulate, charge, demand, take, or receive any higher rate or greater sum of value for any loan or forbearance than 2.5 per centrum per month, when the sum lent is less than 100 pesos, 2 per centrum per month when the sum lent is 100 pesos or more, but no exceeding 500 pesos, and 14 per centrum per annum when it is more than the amount last mentioned, or the maximum rate or rates prescribed by the Monetary Board and enforced all the time the loan or forbearance is granted, a pawnbroker or pawnbroker's agent shall be considered such for the benefit of this act only if he duly licensed and has an establishment open to the public. It shall be unlawful for a pawnbroker or pawnbroker's agent to divide the pawn offered by a person into two or more fractions in order to collect greater interest than that permitted by this section. It shall also be unlawful for a pawnbroker or pawnbroker's agent to require the pawner to pay an additional charge as insurance premium for the safekeeping and conservation of the article pawned. Section 6. The same act is hereby amended by adding the following section immediately after Section 4 thereof, which read as follows. Section 4A. In the exercise of its authority to fix the maximum rate or rates of interest under this act, the Monetary Board shall be guided by the following. Number 1. The existing economic condition in the country and the general requirements of the national economy. Number 2. The supply of the demand for credit. Number 3. The rate of increase in the price level. And number 4. Such other relevant criteria as the Monetary Board may adopt. Section 7. Section 5 of the same act is hereby amended to read as follows. Section 5. In computing the interest on any obligation, promissory note, or other instrument or contract, compound interest shall not be reckoned except by agreement, provided that whenever compound interest is agreed upon, the effective rate of interest charged by the creditor shall not exceed the equivalent of the maximum rate prescribed by the Monetary Board or in default thereof. Whenever the debt is judicially claimed, in which last case it shall draw 6% per annum interest or such rate as may be prescribed by the Monetary Board. No person or corporation shall require interest to be paid in advance for a period or not more than 1 year, provided, however, that whenever interest is paid in advance, the effective rate of interest charged by the creditor shall not exceed the equivalent of the maximum rate prescribed by the Monetary Board. Section 8. Section 7 of the same act is hereby amended to read as follows. Section 7. All covenants and stipulations contained in conveyance, mortgage, bonds, bills, notes, and other contracts or evidences of debts and all deposit of goods or other things whereupon or whereby there shall be stipulated charge, demanded, reserved, secured, taken, or received directly or indirectly a higher rate or greater sum of value for the loan or renewal or forbearance of money, goods, or credits than is here in above allowed, shall be void. Provided, however, that no merely clerical error in the computation of interest made without intent to evade any of the provision of this act shall render a contract void, provided under, provided further that parties to a loan agreement, that proceed of which may be availed or partially or purely at some future time, may stipulate that the rate of interest agreed upon the time the loan agreement is entered into, which rate shall not exceed the maximum allowed by the board, allowed by law, shall prevail notwithstanding subsequent changes in the maximum rate that may be made by the monetary board, and provided finally that nothing herein contained shall be construed to prevent the purchase by an innocent purchaser of a negotiable mercantile paper, usurious or otherwise, for valuable consideration before maturity, when there has been no intention on the part of said purchaser to evade the provision of this act, and said purchase was not a part of the original usurious transaction. In any case, however, the maker of said note shall have the right to recover from said original holder the whole interest paid by him thereon, and in case of litigation, also the cost and such attorney's fee as may be allowed by the court. Section 9. The same act is hereby amended by adding the following section immediately after Section 9 thereof, which reads as follows. Section 9-A. The Monetary Board shall promulgate such rules and regulations as may be necessary to implement effectively the provision of this Act. Section 10. Section 10 of the same Act is hereby amended to read as follows. Section 10. Without prejudice to the proper civil action, violation of this Act and the implementing rules and regulations promulgated by the Monetary Board shall be subject to criminal prosecution, and the guilty person shall upon conviction be sentenced to a fine or not less than 50 pesos nor more than 500 pesos, or 2. Imprisonment for not less than 30 days nor more than 1 year, or both, in the discretion of the court, and to return the entire sum received as in interest from the party aggrieved, and in case of non-payment to suffer subsidiary imprisonment at the rate of 1 day for every 2 pesos, provided that in case of corporation, association, societies, or companies, the manager, administrator, or gerente, or the person who has changed of the management or administration of the business shall be criminally responsible for any violation of this act. Section 11. All acts and parts of acts inconsistent with the provision of this decree are hereby repealed. Section 12. This decree shall take effect immediately, done in the City of Manila this 28th day of January in the year of our Lord 1973. So, 1973. Yun po. So, kung tutuusin mo talaga eh, marami namang ano eh, marami namang existing na batas. Pero nakakapagtaka po talaga bakit napakaluwag ng mga kawalangyaan itong mga nagpapautang. Yun po ang hindi ko talaga maintindihan, kung paano na monopolya to, kung paano na ma-manipulate ito ng mga sindikato. So, talagang nakakalito kasi mula pa nung mga matatagal na usury, no, yung proseso, yung mga amendment. So hindi na natin ano, hindi na natin po nasundan yung mga ano niya, yung mga ordinary tayo, hindi naman po tayo nasa ganitong linya. Hindi na po natin 'to nasundan eh. Hanggang sa nabiktima na tayo eh, kagaya po nang nangyari sa akin eh. So ayun po. Ang nangyari kasi parang ano eh, kutsa-kutsabahan na eh. Siguro maraming nakikinabang sa mga ganitong maling gawain. So isa po to sa ano, ating pag-aaralan. Tingnan po natin at maghahalungkat pa po tayo ng ibang mga, yung mga dati pa na mga lumabas na mga batas noon na po pwede na pa rin natin tumagamit para maibasi natin kung ano yung mga, ano ba yung mga naging pagbabago, ano pa ba yung ano, ano pa ba yung existing ngayon, ano ba yung hindi na existing. Kasi ano eh, may mga ano dito eh, may mga katarantaduhan dito talagang nangyayari sa panahon ngayon eh. Yun po. Kaya sinubukan ko rin itong basahin kasi may nabasa pa nga ako isa na mas ano dito, yung isang usury law. Tsaka yung malalim po kasi yung mga ano nito eh. Yung mga pasikot-sikot dito. So, yun po. Pag-aralan po rin po natin. Maraming salamat po. Mabuhay po kayong lahat.